My dear students, today we are going to start a new chapter, that is combustion and flame. And in this chapter, we are going to study about combustion, types of combustion and ignition temperature, flame, and we will learn about fuels. Combustion is a new term for you. So let us learn the definition of combustion. Burning of a substance in the presence of air is known as combustion. When a substance is burned, it produces carbon dioxide and energy in the form of heat. Look at the picture here. We are burning coal, that means the carbon. In the presence of atmospheric oxygen, it will form carbon dioxide and it will also generate heat. There are varieties of materials from which some of them are combustible and some of them are non-combustible. The materials which burn readily are known as combustible materials. For example, paper, wood, kerosene, diesel, petrol, etc. And some materials which do not burn readily are known as non-combustible materials. For example, glass, metals and ceramic things, etc. Let us perform an experiment to demonstrate the combustion process. Now take a magnesium ribbon and light it. After some time, you'll observe that the magnesium burns with a bright white light to form magnesium oxide and emitting heat and light. Now hold a piece of charcoal using a pair of tongs and bring it near the burner. You will observe that the coal is burning in the air and producing carbon dioxide, heat and light. Hence, it is proved that in combustion, combustible materials burn to produce heat and light. Combustible materials are also known as fuel. Fuel can be solid, liquid or it can be gas. Now, let us perform an activity to demonstrate the combustibility and non-combustibility of some materials. Take some materials such as straw, matchstick, kerosene, oil, paper, iron nail, stone piece and glass. Now, try to burn each of these materials one by one and observe what is happening here. After burning each of these one by one, you will observe that the straw, matchstick, the kerosene, oil, paper will catch fire easily, while the iron nails, stone and glass do not catch fire. By this activity, we can conclude that straw, kerosene oil, matchstick, paper are combustible materials, while iron nails, stone pieces and glass are non-combustible materials. Let us perform an activity to demonstrate the conditions required for combustion to take place. Take a lighted candle and fix it on the table. Put a glass chimney over the candle and rest it on a few wooden blocks in such a way that air can enter the chimney. Now observe the flame. You will observe that the candle burns freely. Now remove the wooden blocks and let the chimney rest on the table and again observe. You will observe that when air does not enter the chimney from below, the flame flickers and produces smoke. Finally, put a glass plate over it and again observe what is happening. You will observe that the flame finally gets extinguished because air is not available. By this activity, we can conclude that oxygen present in the air is essential for the process of combustion. In activity number 6.3, we will again observe that oxygen is necessary for combustion. Now take an iron plate and take piece of burning wood and place it on the iron plate. Now cover it with a glass jar and observe. You will observe that the piece of burning wood gets extinguished after some time, because the supply of oxygen has been stopped. So we can conclude that oxygen is necessary for combustion process. You might have heard when the clothes of a person catch fire, the person is covered with a blanket to extinguish fire. Can you guess why? Because we cover a burning person in the blanket as a first aid. Because we know burning requires oxygen. So when we cover the person with blanket, the oxygen supply is cut off, leading to extinguish the fire and the person is saved. Have you heard about forest fires? Forest fires occur during the hottest summer days. It is occurred due to the extreme heat of summer. Sometimes the ignition temperature of dry grass in the forest is reached, which makes the dry grass catch fire. So when the dry grass catches fire from the grass, it spreads to the trees, and very soon the whole forest is on fire. It is very difficult to control such fires. Our next activity is to understand ignition temperature. Take a piece of paper and a piece of wood and try to burn each of them with the help of a matchstick. Now, you will observe that the piece of paper catches fire easily while the wood does not catch fire. Now, pour some kerosene oil on the wood and try to burn it. You will observe that this time the wood catches fire easily. By this activity, we can conclude that different materials catch fire at different temperatures. Thus, the minimum temperature at which a combustible substance catches fire is called its ignition temperature. Now we can conclude that the conditions necessary for combustion are fuel, air to supply the oxygen, heat to raise the temperature beyond the ignition temperature. All combustible materials need a correct temperature for ignition. Ignition means to catch fire. So, what is the definition of ignition temperature? The minimum temperature at which a substance catches fire and burns is called its ignition temperature. That means that combustible material's ignition temperature. And a substance will not catch fire and burn if its temperature is lower than its ignition temperature. Different substances have different ignition temperature. That is, the ignition temperature of kerosene is less than the ignition temperature of wood. We have already performed this activity, and in this activity you learned that we need kerosene to burn the piece of wood. We performed this activity to let you know that the ignition temperature of paper and kerosene oil is low in comparison to wood or coal. Therefore, a burning paper or kerosene on wood is used to start fire in wood and coal. The paper and kerosene oil catch fire first. This fire causes wood and coal to attain their ignition temperature so that they can also catch fire. So now I suppose that ignition temperature is clear to you. The history of matchstick is very old, about 5000 years ago. The small thin piece of pine wood dripped in sulfur at one end were used as matchsticks. In ancient Egypt, modern safety matchstick was developed only about 200 years ago. Just for your knowledge purpose, read this box only once. In modern days, we use only antimony trisulfate and potassium chloride for safety purpose, and rubbing surface has powdered glass. Add a little red phosphorus, which is less dangerous. When the matchstick is stuck against the rubbing surface, some red phosphorus gets converted into white phosphorus. This immediately reacts with potassium chloride in the matchstick head to produce enough heat to ignite antimony trisulfate, and then it starts the combustion process. That is all for today, students. So read this chapter very carefully.